We are getting set to come to green here for you with four qualifying heat races with Full Raceway. Cheer on your favorite. Make a lot of noise. Let them know you appreciate them as Ross Bales and Craig Glassbergen set to bring them to green here off of turn number four. Green's going to wave, and here we go. They'll drag race down the main straightaway and into turn number one. Ross Bales going to jump to the early race lead. Slides up. Craig Glassbergen going to look beneath him off turn two down the back straightaway. Chris Combs going to be third. Donald McIntosh fourth. Case Bolt fifth. And Bowles sixth here on the opening lap. Bales will lead him through to complete lap number one. Glassbergen will be second. Case Bolt works his way past McIntosh to take the fourth spot down into turn number one. McIntosh out of shape a little bit. May open the door for Bowles to go to fifth down the back straightaway and into turn number three. Meanwhile, Clover, South Carolina's Ross Bales showing the way out in front. Chris Combs in the 47 starting to flex his muscle as he will look beneath the eight of the Austrian Kretzvog, Craig Glassbergen for the second position. Off of turn two down the back straightaway. They'll race into turn number three. Combs to the inside of Glassbergen, side by side for the runner-up slot off four. Coming at you down Main Street here with Raceway. Bales is gone with this one right now. Glassbergen closes the door on Combs in one, and Combs slips back a bit. And the C9 of Steve Casebolt now makes a run, closes in on Combs a bit. As that duo races off turn number four down the front straightaway. As we're halfway home, four down, four to go here in Schaefer's Oil Southern National Bonus Series Heat number one. Or Southern National Series Heat number one. Sorry about that. Bales brings him down to complete lap number five. He's got a comfortable lead, about a half straightaway back to second place running Craig Glassbergen. Chris Combs holding down the three spot. Case Bolt is four. McIntosh five, and Bowles in position number six. And we're going to have two laps to go right here. Again, this is for the pole of the night's Schaefer's Oil A Main. And right now, Clover, South Carolina's Ross Bales has got it well in hand. Working down the back straightaway as Combs is closed back in on Glassbergen for the second position into turn number three. White flag in the air, one lap to settle it. Here in heat number one, Combs and Glassbergen side by side for the runner-up slot down into turn one and two. Down the back straightaway, we'll go for the final time off of turn number four. It's going to be Clover, South Carolina's Ross Bales grabbing the win in heat number one. Second will be Craig Glassbergen. Third going to be Chris Combs. Fourth will be Steve Casebolt. Fifth will go to Donald McIntosh. And sixth will be Stacy Bowles.
We do.
Mac Daddy and Superman set to bring them to green here off turn number four. Green's out. Here we go. McDowell may have spun the tires there. Davenport got a good jump. We'll see if this start stands as they work off turn two down the back straightaway. McDowell out of shape. Going to slip back to the fourth spot, and caution's going to wave. They may have felt Davenport may have pulled the trigger just a tick early. McDowell and Davenport take two, going to try it again. Green is out, and here we go. See how this one shakes out. McDowell jumping out to the early race lead here. Davenport second. Franklin is third. Moses looking beneath. Brancher for the fourth spot as they work off turn number four, and we got caution out again. I believe they're playing cat and mouse up front. And it looks like they're going to move the first row back to the second row. So that's going to put Dennis Franklin and the Super Duck, Donald Bradshaw, now on row number one. Green's going to wave. We'll see what this one rolls out. Franklin with the lead down the back straightaway. McDowell's in second. Davenport third. Bradshaw is fourth. As they work off turn number four, looks like we are going to stay green this time. Franklin showing the way with McDowell in second. Davenport riding in the third spot. Bradshaw fourth. Moses fifth. Then it's Watkins in sixth and Greer in seventh as we come down to complete lap number two. And Davenport starting to close in on second place running McDowell for the bridesmaid spot as they race off turn number two now. and that pair has closed in a bit on race leader Dennis Franklin down into turn at number three. Rambo showing the way. Mac Daddy and Superman going at it for second and third with the Super Duck fourth and Robbie Moses in fifth. Davenport continuing to try to work beneath Madow. Down the back straight away into turn number three. And Superman looks beneath Mac Daddy. He'll take the runner-up slot down into turn number one. As we're halfway home with this one, four down, field working lap number five. Rambo on the point, and Superman has been to the phone booth and changed out of the Clark Kent glasses, and he's running and donned a cape, trying to run down Rambo for the lead. Rambo tied off turn two. Here comes Davenport down into turn number three. Davenport to the lead. But Rambo looking right back beneath him. Does he have some kryptonite for Superman? Nope, not that time by. With two to go. Franklin slips up a bit. That may open the door for McDowell. They're side by side now for second down the back straightaway. They may have made some contact there into turn three. Put Mac Daddy to second as they'll see the white flag off turn number four. And Davenport's machine slows. Davenport slows going down the front straightaway and caution flag is out. And he may have shredded up a tire. Oh my. McDowell, last year's winner here with Raceway, leads him off into turn number one. Donald Bradshaw second, Robbie Moses third. Dennis Franklin up to the fourth spot. Ben Watkins fifth, Travis Greer is sixth as the white flag will wave. One lap to settle it here in Super Late Model Heat number two. As McDowell with this one well in hand, leading him down the back straightaway. Robbie Moses trying to gain some ground on Donald Bradshaw down into turn number three, but off of turn number four. Chickamauga, Georgia's Mac Daddy Dale McDowell be the winner of heat race number two. Donald Bradshaw will come home in second. Robbie Moses going to finish in third. Fourth will be Dennis Franklin in the deuce, followed by the 16 of Ben Watkins and the 11G of Travis Greer, your podium finishers from. As we get set to come to green right here off of turn number four. Green set to wave, and it's out. Here we go. Drag race into turn one, Hill and Overton. Who's it going to be off of turn two? Overton going to nose out in front. Hill going to be in second. Ivan and Lloyd going to be in third. Billy Ogle Jr. fourth. Kenny Collins fifth here on the opening circuit of heat number three. And Overton going to lead them through on lap number one. This is for the outside pole of the night's 53-lap $10,000 to win Schaefer Oil A Main. Race number one of the 2017 Schaefer's Oil Southern National Series presented by Sunoco Race Fuels and Tennessee RV Supercenter. And Ivan and Lloyd looking beneath Vic Hill for the bridesmaid spot. Runner-up up for grabs down into turn number one side by side. Lloyd and Hill and give the Duke to Ivan and Lloyd Jr. He'll take the second position away from Hill as they have motored away from fourth place running Billy Ogle Jr. a bit here in the opening laps of this one. Three down, one lap shy on the halfway point here in Schaefer's Oil Southern National Bonus. Southern National Series heat number three. And it is all Brandon Overton out in front, but Lloyd charging hard off of turn number four, trying to get a run on Overton as we've got four down, four to go in heat number three. We need Super Street Feature Cars to staging. Super Street Feature Cars to staging, please. Lloyd a little out of shape off two right there. Let Hill close in on him a bit as the front three have flat motored away from the fourth and fifth place cars of Billy Ogle Jr. and Kenny Collins. And Overton putting a little bit of breathing distance now between himself and Ivan and Lloyd Jr. as he's going to see the two to go signal here off of turn number four. Two laps to go in Southern National Series heat race number three. Overton going to close it on the slower car of Farrell Skelton here off of turn number four. Coming to the white flag. One lap to settle it here in heat number three. Overton works down the back straightaway for the final time into turn three. He'll bring that machine off turn number four. Evans, Georgia's Brandon Overton, the winner of heat number three. Ivan Lloyd Jr. will be second. Vic Hill going to come home in third. Billy Ogle Jr. will be fourth. Kenny Collins comes home in fifth. And sixth will be the 15 of Mason Massey. It's set to come to green here in the fourth and final heat of the night. Super Street, we need you in staging. Super Street needs to be in staging, ready to go. And Green's going to wave, but they don't know if that one's going to stick or not. Now, caution light is on. A little quick on the trigger right there. Green back out. We'll try it again here in heat number four. As Persley slid up the racetrack, may lose the third position to veteran Billy Hicks. Meanwhile, out in front, it is all Chris Ferguson here on the opening lap. Shannon Buckingham second. Billy Hicks in the 79 will go to third. Johnny Persley in a fourth. Then it'll be Brandon Umberger in the fifth spot. And the 83 machine of Jason Walker rides in sixth. As we've got three laps now officially scored. One lap shy of the midpoint in the final Southern National Series heat of the night. Super Street feature. You need to be in staging. Super Street feature, they need you now. You're up in four laps. And it is all Chris Ferguson out in front. Shannon Buckingham riding in second. Billy Hicks is third. Johnny Persley fourth. Brandon Umberger and Jason Walker. Does Buckingham have anything for Fergie? As we've got five down the field, pretty well strung out here now in the fourth and final Southern National Series heat race of the night. And Fergie, fresh off a Lucas Oil Amateur Dirt Series victory at Fayetteville, North Carolina a week ago Thursday. Trying to get a win and put himself in a four starting position for tonight. Schaefer Oil A Main here at the Fred Brown promoted with Raceway. Coming out off turn number four to the white flag. One lap to go here in our final qualifying heat of the night. Ferguson working him down the back straightaway for the final time. And he will set that car down into turn number three. On the loud pedal off turn number four, Mount Holly, North Carolina's Chris Ferguson, the winner of heat race number four. Shannon Buckingham will come home in second. Billy Hicks going to finish in the third spot. Johnny Persley in the 09 will come home fourth, followed by the 12 of Brandon Umberger and the 83 of Jason Walker. So your top three finishers out of the fourth and final Southern National Series heat of. There they go, race fans. The salute to you great race fans here with Raceway. Get those four wide salute rally towels out and wave them around. If you don't have that, turn the light on your cell phone. We'll get the fireflies buzzing here with Raceway tonight. No matter how many times you see it, it's one of the most beautiful sights in motorsports. How about it with Raceway, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls? It's the Schaefer's Oil Southern National Series presented by Sunoco Race Fuels and Tennessee RV Super Center. Here with Raceway race fans, here they are. And looks like we are getting a one to go signal here, race fans at With Raceway. We're coming to green next time by. Clover, South Carolina's Ross Bales and Evans, Georgia native Brandon Overton. Set to bring them to green. Schaefer's Oil Southern National Bonus Series presented by Sunoco Race Fuels and Tennessee RV Super Center. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's showtime! Ross Bales wins the drag race at turn number one. Overton got a challenge right back beneath him down into turn at number three. Bales with the early lead. Overton going to be in second. As they work down the front straightaway, Chris Ferguson going to go to third. Dale McDowell will be fourth. Craig Weisberg in fifth here on the opening lap. Bales leading them down the back straightaway. About to put lap number two up on the board. Overton a challenge looking beneath him. Down the front straightaway and into turn three. Bales keeps the advantage for the time being. Overton second. Here comes Chris Ferguson. Fergie time looking to the inside of Overton and put Ferguson into the bridesmaid spot. He'll go to second. Move Overton back to third. McDowell is fourth. Weisberg in fifth. Ivan and Lloyd sixth. As Overton changes his line, goes from the bottom to the top as Ferguson tries to reel in race leader Ross Bales. As they'll come by this time and put lap number four up. Overton trying to get a run back on Ferguson for the second position. Not able to do it down into turn number one. As Ivan and Lloyd challenging Craig Weisbergen for the fifth spot and put Ivan into position number five. Meanwhile, Bales continues to lead the way out in front. Ferguson second, Overton third, McDowell fourth, Lloyd is fifth, Weisbergen sixth, Buckingham seventh, Brashear eighth, Combs ninth, and Case Bolt the final car in the top 10 with five laps into this 53-lap event. At race leader Ross Bales will work it off turn two down the back straightaway. Gonna catch slower traffic here in another lap or two. Farrell Skelton will be the first car he'll have to negotiate. Ferguson still riding in second. Overton third, McDowell fourth. Then it's just a bit of distance back to fifth place running Ivan Lloyd. As Bales attempts to put the 0F of Skelton one lap down here off of turn number four. Ferguson looking beneath Bales, though. He had to break his momentum a bit. They're side by side for the lead down into turns one and two. Ferguson easing out in front of Bales now down the back straightaway. They'll duck past the car of Jason Walker. Bales had to check up right there, and that's put Ferguson on the point with nine laps complete. Ferguson now out in front in the double deuce. Bales in second, Overton third, McDowell fourth, and McDowell starting to get some pressure now from Ivan and Lloyd, who rides into fifth spot. Weisbergen is sixth, Buckingham seventh, Richier eighth, Combs ninth, and Vic Hill now in 10th. 10 laps into this 53-lap event. As Ferguson puts another lap up on the board, he's got clear track in front of him here for the time being. The next slower car that Ferguson's going to have to negotiate will be Travis Greer. As we got a couple of cars slow, got a car slowing up to the high side. It looks like Jason Walker, and we're going to have caution. Caution is out. The 83 machine of Jason Walker out of Cullioca, Tennessee. Caution lights are out as we get set to roll them back to green. Chris Ferguson with the field in tow exiting turn number four, and here we go. Ferguson will lead him down into turn one. Bales and Overton going to battle for the second position. Off of two, Overton the rim rides his way past Bales to the second spot momentarily. McDowell keeps Lloyd behind him for the fourth spot. As it looks like the 50 of Buckingham is going to grab the sixth position away from Weisbergen. And here comes Overton. He's going to try to work that top shelf. As they drive off into turn three, he'll dive to the basement here in turn three and four. Gets a good run on Ferguson down a main street here at With Raceway down into turn number one. Ferguson in the bottom of turn one while Overton goes to the top side off of turn two down the back straightaway. Field working, we got 13 in the books. And Overton and Ferguson about to get racy. I believe business is about to pick up at the point. Overton right on Ferguson's back bumper. He'll look to the inside of Fergie in a turn three, side by side for the lead. Off of four, but Overton had to check up a bit, and he's going to lose all that ground that he made up. And Bales may be able to dive beneath Overton for second as they work off turn two down the back straightaway. No, Overton will hang on to that second spot, and he'll start all over again trying to run down race leader Chris Ferguson out for the top spot. But Bales right back beneath Overton, and Bales clear of Overton down into turn number one. Overton fires a slider back up on Bales. Almost nips the concrete, but Ross says, I'll dive right back beneath you, sir, into turn three. And Overton did nip the wall right there, but keeps the car pointed straight. Meanwhile, Ferguson continues to lead the way out in front. Bales now in control of the second position. Overton is third, McDowell fourth. As Vic Hill starts to flex his muscles and work his way through the field, he's trying to get around Ivan and Lloyd for the fifth position. He'll have that done off turn four down the main straightaway. Fergie puts the 0F machine up. Farrell Skelton, another lamb down. He's got clear traffic in front of him for the moment. As Bales rides in second, and we got caution. Caution is out. We've got a car slowed up in turn number one. And the 201 of Billy Ogle's machine rolls slowly up in turn at number one with 18 laps complete. Davenport 27 to 8th at this point. As the caution lights are out, we get set to come back to green. Chris Ferguson in charge of the restart, set to bring them here off turn number four, and here we go. Ferguson will lead the charge into turn one. Bales second. Overton's going to be third. And we have got a massive pileup down in turn one. Mount Holly, North Carolina's Chris Ferguson set to bring the field back to green here off of turn number four, and here we go. Ferguson leads them to charge into turn one. Bales second, Overton third, as Hill gets a run to the bottom beneath McDowell for fourth and trying to get third from Overton down into turn number three. Hill starting to flex some muscle here as he started back in the 10th position here in this one, but Overton will keep him back in fourth for the time being. McDowell fifth, Buckingham sixth, and Davenport is up to seventh. And trying to get sixth from Buckingham down into turn number three. Ferguson continuing to lead the way. Bell second, Overton third, Hill fourth, McDowell fifth, and Davenport around Buckingham for sixth. Keep your eyes on Superman. Hill once again looking beneath Overton for the third spot down into turn number two. As we've got a car spun up into turn two area, caution is out. Billy Hicks is involved. Donald Bradshaw looks to be involved. Farrell Skelton involved in that incident, and I believe Kenny Collins also. So this turn of events puts Ross Bales back on the point. This could get interesting here on the restart. Bales will bring them down, but he's got a lot of heavy hitters behind him. Let's see what shakes out off turn four, and here we go. Bales leads him down into turn one. Overton all the way to the top side of the racetrack, trying to get a run to keep Hill behind him. Off two down the back straightaway. He does for the time being, and Davenport has charged his way to position number four in the 49. Hill looking beneath Overton. That's a battle for second off two down the back straightaway as they close in on race leader Ross Bales. As Dennis Franklin's machine slows here on the front straightaway. And he'll make the left turn into the infield, but caution's gone away. Caution is out. Bowles once again in charge of the restart. Brandon Overton is second. Vic Hill third. Jonathan Davenport fourth. Dale McDowell in fifth. That is your top five with 21 circuits of 53 scored. Bales pulls the trigger on him off turn four, and here we go. Hill may have the second position wrestled away from Overton as they almost got three wide there into one momentarily. Put Vic Hill into the runner-up spot. Move Overton back to third as McDowell and Davenport go side-by-side for the fourth spot off turn four. Coming at you down Main Street right here and put Mac Daddy to the fourth spot now. As Bales leads the way. And here comes Vic Hill trying to close in on Bales for the race lead. Hill will go to the bottom. Bales slides up. Does not stop, but it's going to cost him several positions as he tried to keep it out of the wall. And Vic Hill now takes the race lead. Vic Hill now out in front. Brandon Overton second. Dale McDowell third. As Steve Casebolt challenges Jonathan Davenport for the fourth spot. Third different leader of the event and fourth lead change. Hill, victorious at Tazewell Speedway over the 4th of July holiday weekend and only his third event of the 2017 season. So we've got 25 laps down, about to put lap number 26 on the board, and the Schaefer Oil top 10 at the halfway mark. Hill the leader, Overton second, McDowell third, Davenport fourth, Casebolt fifth, Buckingham sixth, McIntosh seventh, Bales is fell back to eighth, Persley is ninth, Vosbergen is 10th. And McDowell trying to challenge Overton for second, unsuccessful up to this point. As Davenport tries to get a run on the high side of four and gain some ground on that second and third place duo of Overton and McDowell. But Vic Hill continues to lead the way out in front of this one as we'll have 28 complete, a quarter left, 25 remain. Out of shape up in turn four. And Jonathan Davenport sets turned around in turn number four. Caution lights are out. We're going to try it again. Vic Hill sets on the point of this one off of turn number four. And here we go. Overton challenges Casebolt. Overton slides up in front of him. But here comes Casebolt right beneath, back beneath Overton. Down into turn number three, side by side for the lead. Bennett, Shannon Buckingham. He's going to go to the fourth spot here on this restart. McIntosh hangs on to fifth. Vic Hill trying to seal the deal. You understand he may be having some mechanical issues with that race car, but it sure doesn't show it right now. Hill leading the way. Overton is second. Casebolt third. Buckingham fourth. Johnny Persley in the 09s made his way to the top five. He rides in the fifth spot now, does the 09 of Persley after starting into 16th spot. Meanwhile, Vic Hill continues to show the way out in front. 30 down, working lap number 31 of this 53-lap $10,000 to win Schaefer Oil A Main. Hill leads them down once again. Overton second, Casebolt third, Buckingham fourth, Persley fifth, Lloyd sixth, McIntosh seventh, Vosbergen eighth. Davenport torqued his way up to ninth now. And we've got caution down in turn number two. And that looks like the 83 of Jason Walker's machine. Now Overton and Casebolt, it went at it there on the last restart. Let's see what shakes out here now as we get set to come back to green here off of turn number four. Green's out, here we go. Hill leads them off, two down the back straight away. Overton is second, Casebolt is third. Buckingham fourth, getting some pressure from Persley, who rides in the fifth spot. Lloyd six. As Hill continuing to lead the way in the number one machine. When he comes by this time, we'll have 33 laps down. There'll be 20 laps to go in this one, 20 to go here with the Schaefer's Oil Southern National Series tonight at With Raceway. Hill showing the way. Overton still second. Case Bolt is third. Buckingham fourth. Pursley fifth. Lloyd sixth. Davenport back up to seventh. McIntosh eighth. Vosburgh in ninth. And Donald Bradshaw, the final car in the top 10. Less than 20 laps remain now. And Vic Hill keeping somewhat of a comfortable margin back to second place, running Brandon Overton at this point in the event. Case Bolt hanging on to the third position. And Buckingham in the 50 starting to charge a bit and close in on Case Bolt for the third spot. Buckingham trying to dive beneath Case Bolt in three and four, but Case Bolt will not have it. Is that race down Main Street here at With Raceway and put another lap up on the Food Country USA scoreboard there on the back straightaway. Vic Hill will bring that machine down to complete another lap. That is 37 scored. There are 16 laps remaining. It is all the thrill out in front right now. Can he hang on and visit victory lane here tonight for the second time in 2017? He's got about a half straightaway advantage back to the second place running machine of Brandon Overton. Steve Case Bolt holds down third, keeping Shannon Buckingham behind him for the time being. Johnny Pursley fifth, and Jonathan Davenport rides in sixth. And Davenport trying to charge on Pursley and make his way back into the top five, down into turn number one. Davenport trying to slide up in front of Pursley, but not able to do it there. He'll have to get him another run at it. Through turns three and four. Hill goes by. There's a lucky Baker's dozen, 13 to go for your race leader, Vic Hill. Hill brings his machine down off of turn number four. He'll put another lap up. That is a dozen to go. 41 down, 12 remain. Overton is in second. Case Bolt still third. Buckingham has settled into the fourth spot now. Pursley has shuffled Davenport back to fifth and got that fifth position under control at this point. McIntosh seventh. Bradshaw eighth, and Lloyd is ninth. As he'll lead him down the back straightaway once again into turn number three. And he's going to see the 10 lap to go signal right here. 43 complete. 10 to go for race leader Vic Hill in the number one. Overton still second. Case Bolt third. Buckingham is fourth. Pursley and Davenport going at it for fifth now, once again side by side into turn number three. Davenport trying to wrestle that fifth position away from Pursley, but unsuccessful at this point. Yes, Hill comes down the front straightaway. He'll put lap number 45 in the books. There will be eight laps to go as Shannon Buckingham trying to get a run on Steve Case Bolt for third, but unsuccessful at this point. And Pursley back in control of the fifth position now as Davenport has drifted back. And he's getting some pressure now from Donald McIntosh in the seventh, who rides in seventh. As Farrell Skelton will pull the 0F machine into the infield there on the back straightaway. Hill comes by once again, and it's a quick six dash. Six laps remain. Hill continues to show the way. Overton is second. Case Bolt third. Buckingham fourth. And Pursley fifth. And unless something happens, Vic Hill may have himself a victory here tonight at With Raceway. Hill coming off turn number four. There'll be four to go this time, and Overton has closed the gap between himself and race leader Vic Hill. Case Bowl third, Buckingham fourth. Pursley and Davenport renew their battle once again for fifth. But Overton is on the move in the 116, folks. He is closing the gap between himself and Vic Hill with three laps to go, three to go in this one. Overton rolls the top shelf through turns off. One and two down the back straightaway. He'll charge hard into the corner into turn number three. There will be two to go right here. And Overton is closed up within a car length and a half, two car lengths of Hill as they race off into turn number one. Hill slides back up in front of Overton. Down the back straightaway they'll go. Overton looks to the inside of Hill, but Hill closes the door on him here off turn number four. With the white flag in the air, one lap's going to settle it. Overton to the top side, up three and one and two for the final time. They'll go down the back straightaway. Two turns, three and four. Overton to the top shelf. Oh, he gets the concrete wall. Vic Hill will win it with Raceway. Overton's going to hang on for second. Case Bowl third, Buckingham fourth, and Pursley fifth. We'll get him in here and get a few words from tonight's winner, Vic Hill. He said that was a race. First off, talk about your race car. Under caution there, I see the air cleaner's gone. Was you just stopping, try to keep from maybe sucking some more debris down into the carburetor?
Yeah, exactly. Like I said, about the third or fourth lap, and it wasn't anybody left it loose. It broke the stud off that thing, and it flew off. And I thought, man, this thing's got about 850 laps on it. It's going to have to be rebuilt. I knew Jason was here. I said, hell, I'm going to run it. But, man, I got to thank, you know, American Race Tires at this place here. They are super good, and they've won me a lot of races, and they've got a definitely good package for this place. And I appreciate all their help. Ray, for having the series, all you guys, all the fans for coming out. You know, we qualified good, heat raced bad, and raced pretty good. But through all in all, like I said, it was a good night. I want to thank all my help. You know, Stevie and Rich, Jason, Barrett came up here and helped us. Like I said, my wife, I mean, it's good. It's two in a row.
Two in a row. I know we told the fans there earlier during one of the cautions that you had won the last event that you competed in, 4th of July weekend at Tazewell Speedway. And correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe this is only about the fourth time that you've raced here in 2017. So you're batting 500 right now, and you got $5,000 a couple of weeks ago, $10,000 tonight. Congratulations, sir.
You know, it really helps with this racing because it is expensive, and I love doing it. But like I said, I'll run you know, a couple more of these at the end. I'll run Tazewell, Smoky Mountain. I've got to go out and babysit some engine customers out Midwest, but got to do what you got to do. But I really do love this place here, and it's been good to me.
Big round of applause once again to tonight's Shavers Oil Southern National Bonus Series winner here at With Raceway, Vic Hill. Go ahead, Vic. I know you got one more sponsor that I think you left out a while ago. You want to get that taken care of.
Oh, yeah. Like I said, I want to thank Keith Berner, AccuForce. You know, that guy with the shock package he's got me on is really doing good, and he's a good information trail for Vic Hill Racing. Thanks.
And we'll jump in here. Brandon Overton, runner-up finish here tonight at With Raceway, the 2017 Shavers Oil Spring National Series champion. You got a big World of Outlaws win, the Firecracker 100 here a couple of weeks ago. Your car looked like you got going real good there late in the race. You was charging the corners really, really hard, and there on that final lap, it looked like in turn three you just charged the corner just a little bit too hard.
Yeah, Vic kind of stayed up a little higher than he'd been being, and then he darted out in front of me, and then it's kind of choppy getting into three, so I just kind of bottomed out, and you know, I tore it over these guys, but like I said, we just going for it. You know, we had a pretty good car. Just took us a long time to get our tire going. And like I said, I think they're on something a little different than us. But, you know, all in all, good weekend. We'll take it. I guess we're going to do all these things. So, you know, it's a good point tonight. I got to thank all my sponsors, JR Shock, Submission Transport, Henderson Motorsports, CrossFit Overton, Andy Durham Racing, KB Carburetors, all my boys, Josh Pearl and Vinny. Like I said, we'll go on to the next one, see what we got.
Talk just a second. I know looks like the spoiler pretty well used up on the right rear corner, and I know you done that about a third of the way into the event. Did that affect the drive of your race car very much?
Yeah, definitely. You know, on a place like this, I mean, it hurts you. I ain't saying that that's why we didn't win or nothing. Vic did a hell of a job. He was doing what he had to do up there. I hate it for Chris. He had a pretty good car, too. So I said, we're always better on a long run. And, you know, them cautions kept killing me. I couldn't restart good. Every time, if it didn't matter if I went to the top or the bottom, somebody beat me to the corner. So, you know, I haven't been here in a supercar. So, like I said, we got some notes. Come back next year, maybe.
Big round of applause for tonight. Second place finisher, Brandon Overton. Well, slip in here now with third place finisher, Richmond, Indiana, Steve Casebolt. Young man, I think every time I ever get to talk to you, you always finish in the third position. But congratulations. You look like from about the halfway point on, your race car, your Jim Beam and old Masterbuilt got really, really good there for you. And you brought this thing home to a third place finish tonight.
Yeah, the car was really good the whole race. Kind of this track's different. This place is different. It took a little bit getting used to it for me as a driver. We didn't really have our car right till the feature, and I kind of probably could have been a little bit more aggressive early on and maybe made it up through there. I maybe could have crashed or done whatever those other guys were doing. They were doing some crashing, but we struggled all night long, and the guys told me, they said, hey, this race doesn't pay very well for 10th or 12th or 15th. They said, so if you're not any good, pull in. I said, we got a big bucket of candy there on the table. I said, hey, if you want me to pull in, you throw that big bucket of candy and hit me in the helmet with it. So they didn't throw the bucket of candy, so I kept digging and ended up with a third place finish. It was a lot of fun.
And since you jumped in this race car for Jim Beamon, you've been pretty successful, been in the top five just about everywhere you've been, and challenged for a lot of wins along the way.
Yeah, we've been close. We've been really close to some wins. We did pick one win up, but we've had some second, third, fourth, fifth. Yeah, it's been really good, and I think we're just going to keep getting better the longer we go.
Big round of applause to tonight's third place finisher, Steve Casebolt.